a healthy human host has approximately 3 days.
You gotta help me. You gotta help me!
You have to die! Same as pulling the trigger, dragging a knife across our throat!
Lab's locking down.
You gotta get out of here!
Open your eyes! Nobody is coming for us!
Abby, where's the exit?
Ion Entertainment. Ion Entertainment. Keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye. On Entertainment.
Tell us how you got involved in this project.
Well, my dear friend Dylan Vox, who I did The Lair with, the series The Lair, was talking to Ryan and to Domiziano, and they were throwing around, I think, ideas for my role. And Dylan said, Sybil Danning would be great for this role. I said, Dylan, you know, I got to read a screenplay. For me, it's all about the script. Mm-hmm. You know, how, what they say, if it ain't on the page, it ain't on the stage. So when I read the script, I was really very, very happy with the script. And I found it to be very interesting. And I love playing villains. So, of course, playing that character was something that I really wanted to do. I had never worked with Ryan, and I'd never worked with Domiziano, so... It was the script that really, that I liked. And when I met with Ryan and with Domiziano, I liked the guys. I loved their energy. And I loved their vision of this movie and their vision of my character. So here we are.
How did you get started in films?
Oh, my. Actually, by mistake. I was never really interested in doing anything in the movie business. I was a model in Europe. I was a model, and I was making a lot of money as a model, and I was flying all over the world as a model. And one day, one of the photographers that I had worked with called me and said, there's a director looking for a German myth, I guess you could say. She kind of looked like you, only with longer hair, Lorelei. And so I said, okay, why not? So I went and I did that role. It was November. I froze to death. I had to sit on the real cliff overlooking the Rhine River. And I went back to Austria, my home country, like our governor here in California, Arnold. And I said, if that's filmmaking, it's not for me. But then, within the next year, there was two huge pages all of a sudden in Stern, the biggest magazine in Germany, and there I was sitting with my long blonde tresses overlooking the Rhine River, and it made a lot of, you know, headlines. And so then I got another role, and then just one thing led to another, and I got an agent, and...
Well, I saw you in Bluebeard.
Oh, wow.
And, I mean, that,
you were a baby then.
Gorgeous. No,
you were a baby then.
No, and you, I mean, I was just so amazed. How was that experience?
Well, you know, I think any woman in the world would probably say being chandeliered to death by Richard Burton would be a nice thing, at least once a day, you know? So I loved working on that movie because I was always a huge fan of Richard Burton. And I had read his book. I knew where he was from. We had a lot of things in common.
We
spent a lot of wonderful, you know, hours together talking and drinking vodka. And so working on that movie was wonderful.
Entertainment Weekly called you the number one female action star, and you were recently named one of the 12 sexiest werewolves of all time by Latino Review. I mean, that's such great accolades. I mean, this is congratulations on it, and you deserve it.
Thank you. I've been around, you know.
Yes.
And I want everyone to go and see H1N1 Virus X, because the entire movie, the cast, not only the cast, but the crew, the entire crew was wonderful, and it was really hard. But I know Ryan, at one point, he wasn't eating, and I ran after him to give him some chicken. I said, you got to eat or you're going to fall apart. And he says, no. While I'm doing this movie, I'm sleeping, breathing, and living this movie, and that's it. I think he just lived on Coca-Cola. That's it. And as a director, he doesn't let you get away with anything. So I like that in a director.
Okay. Thank you. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, too. Thank you.
Amen.